When I partner with a company to design customer service training, one of the questions I always ask in the design phase of the training is, how do you want your employees to feel as a result of my training? And I partnered with a company recently. Our focus was specifically on empathy. I was brought in to inspire a real culture of empathy. And I asked one of the directors my question, how do you want your employees to feel when they walk out of the training? And the director told me that she needed to think that question over and get back with me. And a couple of weeks later, she got back with me and she said, here's how I want my employees to feel as a result of your training. And here's what I want them to do. And she painted a wonderful picture for me of how she wanted her people to embody the idea of empathy. And she said, imagine that you are at a funeral. And at the funeral, you have three sections of seating. She said, on the first row of the church is going to be the very close family members to the deceased. This may be a spouse, surviving children, parents. These people are very close to the person who has passed away. They are grieving. They are very emotional. They are hurt. And then you have the people in the very back of the church. This may be coworkers, neighbors, friends who know the family, but not necessarily the deceased. So while they are sad, their grief is on a completely different level than, of course, the people on the front row. And then she said, Myra, you have people in the middle of the church. And so they are not as far away from the deceased, of course, as neighbors and coworkers, but yet not as close as a spouse or children. In the middle, we have Aunt Sally. And she said, Aunt Sally is a member of the family. She has a great Aunt Sally, to be specific. She is several miles away from the family, very much a part of the family. She's mature. She's seen a lot. Very wise, very comforting Aunt Sally. She grieves very differently from the people in the first row of the church and differently, of course, than the people in the back. She's more connected. And she said, Aunt Sally is where I want my employees to be when it comes to empathy. I don't want them to be so up close and personal like the family on the front row. That is, I don't want them to feel sympathy. I don't want them to become overly involved or overly emotional. Yet I don't want them to be kind of back row. That's too distant, too disconnected. Aunt Sally would be the one that would walk up after the service and offer a hug or a Kleenex. She's there. She's comforting. She knows what to say, and she's not in deep pain herself, yet she knows how to listen. She knows what to say. She knows if a hug is appropriate. Aunt Sally, Myra, is what I want our people to walk away being. I want them to feel that role and display that role. I think that is a wonderful analogy, and that's exactly what we went with in that training. It was perfect for that company, and I don't know your company or your customers, but I suspect the Aunt Sally idea may be appropriate for you as well. I don't want you to be back pew, distant, not saying anything, maybe quickly heading back to work or your home after the service. No, I want you to be there like Aunt Sally, listening, you know, taking advantage of the opportunity to pause and take it in and to know what to say, to know when it's best to say nothing at all. And we're not going to be on the front pew getting too far into our emotions. So I share the Aunt Sally approach with you as an idea, a visual of where you need to be as you work to convey empathy to your customers.